from not going according to the program, we will throw another curveball here. Since we have done the boys already in the first half, we will now play a piece by a composer who, well, the name all of you know extremely well. The music of that person, I bet you $100, nobody knows. Johann Gottlieb Goldberg. You all know the Goldberg Variations by Johann Sebastian Bach.
Sorry.
See, I'm already right. Yeah, perfect. This was not arranged, but he reads my mind.
Yeah.
Fantastic. That's what you do after 25 years of playing an ensemble. So, thank you, guys. Johann Gottlieb Goldberg was a student of Johann Sebastian Bach for a few years, and he was in the employment of a duke who was an insomniac, and he would say, "Johann Gottlieb, play me something. I can't sleep." So he took the variations that Johann Sebastian Bach, his teacher, wrote, namely those with the 30 variations, it's over an hour long a piece, and probably played that for him. If that is legend or truth, we shall never know, and it matters not, because the man, Johann Gottlieb Goldberg, was also a composer in his own right, and he wrote wonderful trio sonatas and a quartet sonata, and since we brought our latest recording, you may have seen that yellow sign, the complete chamber music of Johann Gottlieb Goldberg, we thought it might be a nice or good idea to introduce you to that composer. So our next piece on the program is the sonata in B flat, the opening track of our CD, the opening tracks, I should say. And the movements are as follows. It starts with a beautiful adagio, followed by a allegro, which is a fugue. The man was a fantastic chromatic fugue writer, you will hear. Followed by a short and brief and rather eccentric grave, and then followed by as I personally think, one of the most beautiful circonas written in the, let's say, mid-18th century. When you listen to the bass line that sort of gets repeated over and over, modulates, it is not your usual four notes as in the Schmelzer, bom, 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 but it is bom, 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 bom. It is almost atonal when you look at it by itself. Anyway, that's a fantastic piece, and of course that is on our CD, and you're certainly welcome if you like that piece, and I bet you will take it home with you. You are the first people. The CD officially gets released on November 1st. I picked it up 3 days ago at the record company in Westchester County in New York, and you are the first people who will be able to purchase that CD. That should be an incentive, I hope. Anyway, here is Johann Gottlieb Goldberg Sonata in B flat major.
Thank you.
people walked up to me and asked many questions about the instrument, so I will just, in a nutshell, give you all the information that you, that many of you wanted to know. First of all, the instruments, yes, they are just regular violins, no gamba or anything like that, just regular violins and a cello, but they are in the setup, the Baroque setup, which is actually the way they were originally set up back in the 17th, early 18th century. They had all been modernized, and now we had to re-Baroque them 25 years ago, 20 years ago, this one, in this case. We have two Jakob Steiner instruments, one from 1660, one from 1668.
I'm the older brother.
Yes, as you can tell, as you can see. And my wife is always right. I had to say that. And we have a beautiful cello by Peter Rombouts from Amsterdam, 1710, if I'm correct. Yes. You can tell the differences. There's no end pin. There's several technical differences. Here, we don't have a chin rest. We don't have a shoulder rest. We don't hide anything here either. So we have to balance very differently. It's a whole different animal, so to speak. Takes a while, but it gives you freedom. Since Baroque music is all based on dance music originally, you can really walk and dance and do what you need to do. The harpsichord, Dr. Sark, maybe you say something.
The harpsichord,
quickly.
Luckily, it has a year on, so you can tell that it's only made in 1987.
By?
It is made by me from a kit, a Zuckerman kit that's from Stonington, Connecticut, decorated beautifully by a woman named Chris Bevilacqua. It is made to look like a Flemish style instrument you might see in a Vermeer painting. The Latin in the lid is always asked about, so I will tell you briefly what it says. Yeah. Now, the spellings are odd. I have been told by experts that they are, in fact, odd but okay. They are taken verbatim from old harpsichords. These are two of about 50 of them that survive. So the one on the left says, "While living I was silent, now dead, I sweetly sing." It is talking about the tree that doesn't make any noise when it's alive, but once you cut it down, you can make nice sounding things out of it. In a French harpsichord of the 18th century, they say the same message on every soundboard on a French harpsichord. They always have a tree stump with one living branch growing out of it and a bird singing on it. Visual. Version of that. The other one on the right says, "If these be the joys of this world, what be the joys of heaven?" I'm not sure I felt that much after the week of debates, but in our little world here, we have a form of heaven, I hope.
Recorder is a recorder. The traverso that Matthias played. Well, it hasn't changed. The modern flute now is made of silver or gold or both, and of metal, in other words. Of course, the traverso is of wood and has a totally different sound, as you heard. And our plain gut strings make the instrument sound very different. But also the bows, and you saw us even switching to different bows for the later music. We use a 18th century Baroque bow that is convex rather than concave, as a modern bow is. It's about 4 to 5 inches shorter, has much less hair, has an open frock, no metal at all with the exception of the screw that goes on the inside. The other bow does not even have a screw. It's called a clip-in frock. You clip the frock between the stick and the hair, and you tighten with very authentic pieces of cardboard, matches or leather or whatever does the job, so to speak. And they make a very different sound. That the other bows are even another 2 inches shorter than this bow. So more articulate, more overtones, less of the Rolls-Royce feeling of a modern bow. That in a nutshell. Before we go to the last piece, just wanted to mention that most of the pieces that we played tonight are on different CDs of ours. The Mancini is on the Concerto di Napoli disc. This final piece that we will be playing is on our Telemann Sonata a 5 e 4 CD. The Marini is on a CD. The person who sells the CDs can tell you. I instructed them very deliberately. And the Goldberg, obviously, on our latest CD. I always make that pitch, and I think it's very important to know when you buy CDs directly from the artists, you are really supporting the artists. We have made CDs for almost 20 years now. I have not ever seen one penny of royalties. I'm still waiting. So if you feel, if you like the music, if you feel like supporting the arts, this is one way of doing it very directly, and you take some gorgeous music home with you, I will promise you. And I'll leave you with that, and we play this wonderful quartet concerto by Telemann. Thank you.